Hi guys, in this video we are going to discuss about regular expressions, regular grammar and regular languages. In the previous video we have seen faces of compiler. Among all the faces, the very first face which we have discussed is named as lexical analyzer. The entire lexical analysis phase is functioning based on regular expressions, regular grammar and finite automata. The simulation model or abstract machine of regular expression, regular grammar is termed as finite automata. Now let us get into the topic. What is the meaning of regular expression? What are all the operations involved in it? How the regular languages are generated with the support of regular grammar or regular expression? There is a scientist, Noam Chomsky. Noam Chomsky have brought hierarchy of abstract representation of the language, that is type 0, type 1, type 2, type 3 language, or else it is termed as regular grammar, context-free grammar, context-sensitive grammar, phrase-structured or unrestricted grammar. These are all the four grammars helps in designing any of the computer programming language. This is the abstract notion or the mathematical foundation or abstract mathematics plays a vital role in designing any of the programming language, computer programming language. Among all the four languages of Noam Chomsky hierarchy, regular language or regular grammar is most restricted type of grammar. What is the meaning is, its power of computation is lesser. Although it does the activities or necessary supports for lexical analysis, the power of computation is lesser when it is compared with all other type of grammars like context-free grammar, context-sensitive grammar and unrestricted grammar. Now, the moment we say grammar or language, even a natural language, human language, any time we start learning a new language, we start with an alphabet. Similarly, in the abstract machine also, abstract notion also, alphabet is the basic building block in building grammar, subsequently in generating the language. The symbolic representation of alphabet is denoted with this symbol, sigma. Whenever we see sigma, that signifies input alphabet. Now, what are all the possible operations or basic operations we can perform on the alphabet is the next part of discussion. This phi. Phi is the regular expression used in the regular language. Phi is the regular expression that generates phi as a language. What is the meaning? This meaning is null. Null means ultimately in any operation, if it gets associated, the entire operation would lead to null. I can say it is equivalent to logical zero. So any operation when we perform that leads to null value. Subsequently, epsilon. This epsilon is a regular expression. It generates epsilon as a language. What that signifies? This signifies the empty set, empty generation. Subsequently, A belongs to epsilon. This denotes A is the alphabet, belongs to epsilon. I'm considering only one symbol into the alphabet, that is the input alphabet. Then what would be the regular language? For the regular expression, I'm substituting A as an alphabet symbol. Then the language would become again A. That's it. Because only one is involved. There is no other operators involved. There is no basic operation involved in this alphabet. So that the outcome would be, the output would be A. Subsequently, we are moving to R operation. This denotes R. Plus symbol is termed as R operation. Otherwise, instead of the plus, we can use this slash also. We can use this union symbol also. These three symbols together denotes R operation upon the given alphabet. Let us consider A and B are the two alphabet symbol given to the regular expression for the operation R. Now the output of this operation would become either A or B. This is the language generated by the expression or the grammar. Let us move on to the next operator. The next operator is termed as concatenation operator. This concatenation operator either can be represented with a dot or without any other representation, just writing subsequently. We are substituting two different symbols A and B to the regular expression that generates the language AB. Or we can substitute A dot B. The output of this expression or the language of this expression would become A comma B. Next operator, we are going to discuss clean star. This star is denoted as clean star or clean closure. Otherwise, we can say it as clean closure. Either of the term we can use. Now, what is the role of this clean closure? Given the alphabet, if we consider A as an alphabet, then this operation star would lead to the use of this operator starts from zero and goes with infinite. Many times A can occur. Now, the language generated by this expression, let us see. The language generated by this expression would start with epsilon, followed by, if the star is substituted with the value 0, we will be obtaining epsilon. If the star is substituted with the value 1, the outcome would become A. If it is 2, it would be AA. If it is 3, it would be AAA, and so on. We can compute infinite times of A. The power of star is starting with 0 goes up to infinite number of times. Now, let us move on to clean positive closure. Instead of this star, we will be using this plus symbol. Now, what is the meaning of this plus? The minimum value of this plus starts with 1 and it goes up to infinite. So that the first output of the language generated by A plus is A, because there is no 0. Starts with 1, so that A. And subsequently, it can generate the language AA, can generate the language AAA, and so on. Now we can see the language generated by clean star is epsilon AAA. Clean positive star is AAAA, AAA, and so on. Now, with respect to compiler design, how the regular expression is helpful, or regular language is generated, or certain examples, let us see. Set of vowels I want to represent using regular expression. How can I represent A, E, I, O, U? These are all the five symbols termed as vowels in a language. A union. Either we can write A union or we can write like this also. This expression otherwise rewritten like A plus E plus I plus O plus U. Either we can write like this or else A R E R I R O R U. Either way we can represent. These all denotes R operation. The language generated by this expression would become this. A comma E comma I comma O comma U. That's it. Now let us move to the second example. We are defining the pattern A followed by zero or more occurrences of B. This is called pattern or statement of the expression or formulation of the expression or problem statement. Now, this emphasizes A followed by zero or more occurrences of B. A followed by zero or more occurrences of B. A is mandatory, so that A dot concatenation followed by, then concatenation operation we need to use. Subsequently, it is mentioned that zero or more occurrences of B, The moment we read zero or more occurrence, clean start, B start. The language generated by this expression would become always starting with A followed by zero or more occurrences. If B to the power of star becomes B to the power of zero, then only the A is a result of the expression. If we substitute one for this star, then AB would become the result. If we substitute 2 for this star, ABB would become the result. If we substitute 3 for this star, ABBB would become the result. If we substitute 4 for this star, then A4B and so on. Let us see one more example also. Problem statement or explanation or expression. Any number of vowels followed by any number of consonants. Other than vowels, B, C, D, these are all termed as consonants. Where V is the vowel, C is the consonants. Here, the freedom is given. Any number of vowels followed by any number of consonants. So that we are using V star dot C star. V is the representation of set of all possible vowels. C is the representation of set of all consonants. How we can represent this? For example, V is equal to, we can represent A, R, E, R, I, R, O, R, E. Similarly, consonants we can represent like this, A to Z, subtract V. Exclusive of V, all other symbols or remaining symbols are termed as consonants. Now, how this could generate any combination? If we substitute 0 for both star, epsilon. Then if we substitute 1 here, only the vowel. In any combination, we can generate. But mandatory condition is either it can start with the vowel or it can start with the consonant. Only two options. Never it can start with the consonants followed by vowel is possible. Either we can start with vowel followed by consonants is are possible, or we can start with the consonants alone. Once the consonant is started, there is no scope for bringing vowel. That is the only constraint in this grammar. The entire lexical analyzer for the scanning process of the source language in order to identify token or string or lexeme, these are all the regular expressions helpful for identifying the patterns or tokens. Let us see few more example. Union of two languages, L and M. Let us say L is one of the language, M is yet another language. Union of two languages leads to either language of L or language of M. That's it. Concatenation of two language, L is one language, M is one language. In this case, language M always would be followed by language L. That's it. Clean closure of language L. Zero or more occurrences of the language L. Notations. Major notations available in the regular expression or grammar are only three. Union, concatenation, clean star. There are two special symbols. Phi is useful for denoting the null operation or null value. Epsilon is useful for denoting the empty operation, the empty value. Then simple R is a regular expression mathematically used, and L of R is the mathematical representation to denote regular language. Then more than one operation also we can perform. The combination of R and concatenation, combination of clean star and concatenation, clean positive star and R operations, something like that. Now let us see precedence and associativity among these all the operators. Star has the highest precedence and concatenation has the next precedence. Pipe symbol R has the least precedence. When it comes associativity, when the associativity will place a role? Whenever all the operators are having the equal precedence, then the associativity will play a role. In which left associative will be used. There is no right associativity at all. All the operations uses only the left associativity. That means left to right scanning will happen. Now, star has the highest precedence, concatenation has the highest precedence, pipe symbol has the lowest precedence among all operators. Now, X star means zero or more occurrence of X. One more example. This is equivalent to epsilon. This E is equivalent to epsilon followed by X, XX, triple X and 4X, etc. Similarly, the next is X plus. That signifies starting with 1 and continues up to infinite. So that no epsilon. Other than epsilon, every other element would be derived by the regular expression X plus. X star will have one additional component, that is epsilon. X plus will have exclusive of that epsilon. That is the only difference. X question mark. This comes into Lex tool. This means either X or empty. It can generate either the symbol given X or empty epsilon. A to Z is useful for ranged data. This signifies lowercase alphabet of English language. Capital A to Z, this signifies uppercase alphabet of English language. 0 to 9 is the ranged data. This is used to represent natural digits. Now let us see, using these all kind of ranges, how we can construct a regular expression. Now, representing occurrence of identifier and numbers using regular expression. Identifier, always in a computer programming language, we used to study, starts with alphabet followed by any number of alphabet, digits or underscore. Now let us see, letter is the variable or the term we are coining with the representation of the regular expression A hyphen Z, capital A hyphen Z. This represents ranged data from A to Z. Only the comprises of only the lowercase letters. This is the ranged data starting with uppercase A and ends with uppercase C. It comprises of only the uppercases. Similarly, digit A or 1 or either this way we can represent, or we can use the ranged data 0 or 9. Sign is represented plus or minus. This is called OR operation, union operation. Decimal is represented sign. Decimal is represented sign to the power question mark. What is the meaning of question mark is star we cannot use for representing infinite times in a language or in a computation. So that we are using a special symbol or operator called question mark. This question mark, either it accepts one time or it generates empty. The term can be empty or it gives only one occurrence. Then digit plus, clean star. Minimum one need to be generated. In the computation, we cannot use star also because epsilon, emptiness cannot be represented by a computer. So that always we may need to use finite representation as well as the minimum representation plus. So what is the meaning this signifies? Definitely we will not give infinite number of digits. Being a user, we used to give only a finite number of digits only in a number. So that never it would lead to infinite loop or infinite situation. So that plus. Plus signifies minimum one digit should play a role. Infinite never will occur. Similarly, this question mark signifies minimum one time it can be or it could become empty. The term can become empty. So the sign either plus or minus can play a role, or no need to occur that symbol representation at all. Simple 50 we can write. No need to represent plus 50, or we can represent minus 50. Now identifier. Identifier is represented with a regular expression. This is a regular expression. These are all alphabet. Now we are defining alphabet for letter, alphabet for digit, alphabet for sign. Now these two are example for typical regular expression. This is to recognize the decimal values. This is to recognize an identifier. So these two are the regular expressions helpful for lexical analysis phase. Not only these two, there are many more. The vital or important regular expressions which plays a role in lexical analysis are decimal representation and identifier representation. Now let us see, this decimal is formulated with a regular expression, sign to the power of question mark, digit followed by plus. Similarly, identifier is represented with letter, letter or digit. So any identifier, if you look at, when we declare variable also, when we coin a function name, user defined function name also, we used to start with letter, followed by we used to give letter or digit. Star is given, that is fine. But never we give infinite representation of variable in the program declaration, so that there is no unsafe mode of execution will happen because of this star. Nothing to worry about it. Because these are all the regular expressions works on user written language. We used to write a program called Hello World, sum of two number, and we used to write a projects. All those things defined and well written by an user. User cannot represent infinite way of writing either identifier or the number, so that it will work in the safe mode. Now, this is food for thought. Start working on these three MCQs. Which one of the following languages over the alphabet 0, 1 is described by the regular expression 0 or 1 the whole star, 0, 0 or 1 the whole star, 0, 0 or 1 the whole star? This is the given regular expression. The combination of concatenation, union and clean star, all together it plays a role. You need to find out the answer for this question. Similarly, the regular expression 0 star, 1, 0 star, whole star denotes the same set as what? Ultimately, I am giving the expression and asking you to find out the corresponding regular language. That's it. Here regular expression is given. You may need to find out the regular language, or here in this case, equivalent regular expression. The regular expression for the language having input alphabets A and B in which two A's do not come together. Never two A's should sit together or should occur adjacently. This is the constraint for this question. You may need to find out the appropriate answer for this question. With these three questions, I would like to end this video. Thank you for watching.